Should I stay?
What?
I don't want to sleep in the treehouse tonight, but I don't know if I should leave. What if my parents come home?
I won't leave you alone.
Well, let's go somewhere safe that's close, okay?
That's a good idea. Hey, man! Bullshit! Don't eat us! We're not gonna hurt you.
Yeah. I thought for a second you and the little one were both gonna give us the chomp.
We need help.
Are you trying to get out of here? Because you should be. Those things are all over the damn place. I haven't seen anything as gnarly as this neighborhood since downtown Atlanta, 15 miles back. I'm Sean. Sean Green.
Lee, this is Clementine.
I'm Chet.
We shouldn't be out in the open like this. How about you help us clear the way, and we'll take you and your daughter out of here and down to my family's farm. It should be safe there.
Another day. A neighbor. Their parents are out of town.
Let's get going. Staying put for too long is a mistake.
What do you want to do?
Monster's coming.
Sean, I'm gonna run on home. My thumb is gonna get sick.
No sweat, man. I'll catch you tomorrow night.
It was nice to meet you both.
Thank God you're okay.
I was worried it'd be bad here, too.
Been quiet as usual the past couple days. Breaking down the way things of mayor's gone late, but that ain't nothing.
I wouldn't have made it back without Chet.
Well, I'm glad you took him with you then. You brought a couple guests.
Your boy's a lifesaver.
Glad he could be a help to somebody. So it's just you and your daughter then?
Oh, not his daughter. He was her neighbor.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yes.
Okay then. Looks like you hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Yeah. So I'm doing something.
I can help you out. Sean, why don't I let him check on your sister? You take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is swollen to hell.
Worse.
That's what it sounds like. Seems like things got awful bad in the cities. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green. How'd this happen?
Car accident.
That's so.
Where were you headed?
Before the car accident. didn't get your name, darling.
Clementine.
Can't imagine what you've been through, Clementine.
I'm looking after her until we find your parents.
Hey, Dad. So I'm thinking, first thing tomorrow, we gotta reinforce the fence around the farm.
That doesn't seem necessary.
I don't know what you saw on TV or heard on the radio, but there's some serious shit hitting the fan. I don't think anyone knows how big it is yet.
Your son's right. You're gonna want to fortify this place.
Stuff like that doesn't happen around here, Sean.
Dad, I'm serious. Lee, come on. Tell him what you saw out there, man.
I got chased by a couple of dead people.
Well, do what you think you should. We got plenty of chores as it is.
Lee and those folks in the barn can help out in the morning. We gotta do it. Really.
I already said okay. Well, I'm all done here. You should start to feel better tomorrow.
Thanks.
The lake is hot or the swelling doesn't go down, you're probably dealing with an infection.
What do we do then?
We'll probably just have to shoot you. We'll clean it, redress it, and you'll be fine.
Okay, that'd be preferable.
There's blankets and such in the barn. We'll be seeing you bright and early. Come tomorrow, which way you think you're headed?
Towards Lincoln, I suppose.
You slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm not a dad. Thanks, Lee. I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of a fence. There's a tractor and everything.
We better get going, or we won't hear the end of it. That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Duck, though.
Duck?
Yeah, nothing bothers him. Like water off a duck's back, you know?
That's a valuable treat lately.
No kidding. But frankly, I think it's because he's dumb as a bag of hammers.
Dad!
But he makes up for it with enthusiasm. The word is, you were on your way to Macon.
My family's from there.
Well, Macon's on the way, and personally, I'd appreciate the company of a guy who can knock a couple of heads together if he has to. Plan then. Honey, Duck, this is Lee. And what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
I want to build a fence.
Yeah? Well, I need a good foreman. You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On a tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to you.
I can keep an eye on your little girl here on the porch. We can visit.
Help?
What do you mean?
I mean, what you're doing? You got kids of your own?
I think I've got it handled. As long as I keep her safe, I think I'm doing all right.
With those things out there, maybe. Sure, that's enough. But you gotta ask yourself if you're the type of guy who can do better than that if her parents don't show up.
I'll keep that in mind. So what's your family's plan?
Get back on down to Lauderdale and let this mess get sorted out. The government will start handing out shots and the National Guard will do its thing. On the odd chance things got too bad, we could hop on by boat, I guess.
You've got a boat.
I'm a commercial fisherman, catching mackerel, dolphin, whatever's biting and paying. Katya wouldn't be wild about it, but the boat's not that bad.
Veterinarian back in Fort Lauderdale, like Herschel here, except more with dogs and cats and not horses. What is it that you do, Lee?
We used to teach up at the University of Georgia.
We need to hope that we can go back to our jobs soon. Back to normal. It can't stay like this.
No, I used to. I was let go a little while back.
That's too bad. Well, I hear people always clamor back to college after a big disaster. People don't want to die ignorant, I guess.
You two actually look relaxed.
I think we're doing just fine. Clementine was just telling me about first grade.
Oh, how's that?
It's easy.
Well, yeah. So, you good?
Anyway. It's almost like we didn't see people eating each other for the past 3 days. It's peaceful.
How did you handle getting to the city?
Can you just drove? We passed so many people that needed help, and we just passed people over some. Just.
It's okay. It's fine. You don't have to say anything.
I want to go home tomorrow. But even then, I can't take away the things we went through. Don't you want to go back to the moment before you knew about all of this?
Anybody in their right mind? Families, barbecues, beers with good friends.
All of those things.
Those are the things we live for, right? With those gone, what's the point? Back in a bit.
Okay.
Besides the length, that sure speed things up. Dad doesn't know how bad it is.
No, he doesn't.
I saw a guy in Atlanta kill a kid. A boy. Just shot him right in the face.
Was the boy one of the walkers?
I don't even know. He was either attacking the guy or asking for help. He didn't even hesitate. Turned, put the barrel of the gun right between the kid's eyes, and pulled the trigger. You don't see things like that. It's not like in the movies.
You don't fall like you think.
Did you have to do it?
Do what?
Kill. Have you had to offer one yet?
Oh. I had to shoot one.
I could shoot one. Maybe. If it were far away. I'm just glad we're getting this fence built. Dad just wants to keep the family safe. Makes a lot of people think whatever's out there. How about yours? How's your family?
My brother and parents are in Macon.
Oh, man.
Perhaps so too.
Maybe it's not too bad there.
That's probably all I need cut for now. Thanks.
Hey, Sean. Thanks again for the ride.
No problem, Paul. Couldn't leave you behind. Anyway, when you see my dad around, he might want some help.
Plot of land.
If you told me 20 years ago I'd still be doing this, I would have told you that you were full of crap. Never was a plan, having a place like this. It was in the family, and yes, so was I. Family's important. It's all that matters. You agree with that?
Was brought up to, yes.
Where's your family now? Parents, wife, girlfriend?
My parents are big.
Now you've got this little girl to take care of. Clementine, is it? You just stumbled up on her?
Yeah, I was looking for help in her house.
Can I give you a piece of advice?
Sure.
I don't know who you are or what you did, but you better become a better liar. Let's say things don't get better back in the cities, or they get worse before they do. You're gonna have to depend on the honesty of strangers if you're gonna make money. And if those same people get to questioning yours, you're gonna be in trouble. So whoever you are and whatever you did, keep it to your damn self. But at least you have the common sense to listen to a man giving you advice.
Sorry? Your son is alive.
You don't get to be sorry.
you tried to help him, but this piece of shit let him die.
You can't blame Kenny.
The hell I can't. You watch your back. He kills your daughter. You need his help.
Please. Just go.
Get out and never come back.
That ride to Macon if you want it.
This is as far as we're going.
Then it's far enough.
Look!
Hey there! You friendly? Truck's run out of gas.